What is up, everyone? Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be going over the new slash execute command in Minecraft Bedrock. So as you can see, this new slash execute command has been completely redone compared to the old slash execute command. So before we get started, we're gonna have to go through how you can actually get this into your world, because it's not public released by the time I'm creating this video. You might be watching this later, and it's probably released by then, because this new command is a very almost completely out. It is still in a little bit beta, but I'm gonna show you guys how to get this thing in your world first. All right, so first you're gonna be going into your world. If you need to create a new one, you might need to. All you will need to have added is upcoming creator features. So make sure you have upcoming creator features toggled, and also you need to activate cheats, because how are you going to run the commands without that? But yeah, so we're going to play the world and we're going to get started. So if you remember, or you might never have learned, the old slash execute command was really just target selector based. So what you would do is you do execute at A or at E or at P. So let's just say we did at S, let's just do an if statement. So an old if statement would have run like this. So we do slash execute at S, type equals player. So we're testing if I'm a player, and if score equals, we would do something like this, objective name. So whatever the objective name was, B, and if it was 256 or something like that. Basically, then you can run a command on that player syntax by doing this, and then you would do run, or you would do say hey. So obviously that doesn't work, because this is the old framework. So the new one has been completely redone, and it's actually a little more complicated, but it's also a lot more understanding for people just looking at the command to understand what's actually going on. So as you can see, we have six different augments we can run based on the first execute syntax. So we have six subcommands. So the first one is as, the second one, oh, okay. So the first one is as, basically meaning we can do slash execute as, and then we can select an origin, meaning the target. So we would do slash execute as if we're an entity. So we're gonna execute all entities as, so basically meaning execute as this entity type. So execute as at E, so meaning execute as all entities at. So basically we have the same six subcommands as we did before, meaning this is the same command, it's just being ran again. So it's execute as at E, so execute all entities at. So we're going to use the at, meaning we're executing all entities as if we're the entity. So for each, okay, it's basically meaning execute as all entities for each entity. So we're running for each entity at its same position, and then we're going to run say hey. So look at that. So it's ran through all the entities. Open chat, there we go. All right, it's executing all the entities, and it's saying hey for each one of those. So let's say we only wanted to do players. So we do at A, and you can see it only does players. Let's say we wanted to do all entities that are only foxes. So this type equals fox. And there you go. You can see all the foxes are saying hey. Say hey, I'm a fox. So as you can see, all the foxes are saying hey because they're a fox. And simply, it is just that easy if you wanted to use the old framework. So basically, the execute as at is the old syntax, and basically acts like it is the old syntax. So, but this new execute command isn't that simple. What we can do with this is also at. So at, obviously the same thing, so we're gonna do add at s, run, say hey. So same exact thing, but it's at, and it's a little bit shorter than as. So as is for each, at is just the original origin target. So then we have if. So usually you wouldn't want to run if positioned or unless before you target an entity, because it doesn't really work well and it doesn't really work as if it should, but you can still do it. So we're just going to learn this after we run the rest of the commands. So basically what we're going to be doing is we're going to execute all entities as if we were a fox. Then we're going to do at their fox's position. And so we're going to do at s. And we're going to do run summon cow. So as you can see, all the foxes, where are they? Little foxes, there we go. So you can see at all the foxes' coordinates, at their coordinates, meaning at, it's going to run summon cow. The same thing also goes with positioned, but this also allows you to change a little bit of coordinates. And you can also do positioned, let's say positioned 10 blocks above that animal, we can run summon cow. So as you can see, 10 blocks above the foxes. So you can see it's summoning a cow 10 blocks above the foxes. And yeah, so basically what that means, it's going to summon cows. So it's going to execute as you're the fox, positioned 10 blocks above me. So this is executing 10 blocks above the sender. And we don't want to execute above the sender. We want to execute as if we were the fox. So we're going to do positioned as at s, positioned 10 blocks above the fox, run summon cow. So as you can see, there is now cows summoned above all the foxes 10 blocks above them. So before, as you can see, we were running positioned 10 blocks above myself, because I'm not positioned as something, I'm positioned as myself. So when we add that as at s, that makes it positioned not myself, not my at s, it's positioned as the for loop's at s. So without that as at f, we're positioned to the command sender, and with that at s, we're positioned as the for each of whatever as we are. There you go. So basically, that is some simple syntax if we want to run positioned or if we want to run stuff like that. So we're going to delete all that. And we're also going to run through the if statements and unless statements, because they are very, very cool. So let's say we want to run through all players. So execute as at A. And we're going to test if their score of that player, the score of the player, is the objective money, we had a credit, matches, or we can do, actually, no, instead of matches, we'll do greater than 2. We are going to run, oh, 2 at s, run, actually, syntax a little weird on these, I forgot, positioned, oh, this is the old syntax. Oops. So this is going to be positioned money equal. So basically meaning score matches at s money equal. But we can also do matches. I think this allows us to input a number. Yep. Okay. So if money matches 9, then we're going to run say hey. So there we go. It doesn't work. So we're going to do scoreboard players, scoreboard objectives, add money dummy. Okay, and we're going to do scoreboard players add itself money 9. And as you can see, when we run that command, I said hey, because my money matches 9. And it's as simple as that. I mean, you might be able to run double dots. Let me see if that works. Run say hey. Oh, you actually can. So if your money is greater than 9, you can see that these double dots just mean greater. If I do 2 dots below, it means it's less. And I think we still have syntax with 9 between 20. That still works. Yep. So now if I add more money, it will fail. Yep. Because it failed because my money is not the greatest. So set display, sidebar, money. So you can see my money's 27 and it wanted to test if my money was between 9 and 20. So there you go. That super simple new execute command framework is actually so easy to understand, and it's actually really nice, and I like it. So there's also really few more things we got to go through. Unless basically means it's the same as if, but it's just else. So it's if, but unless something happens. So we're going to execute as all players unless their score money matches 9 between 20. Run command Run say hey. Okay, so as you can see, it is running, but if we switch that back to that old if statement, you can see this actually does not run. Because if test if that condition is true, unless checks if it's not true. So unless checks if that same condition is not true, if tests if it is true. Simple as that, and it's really simple to understand. So a few more things we got to go through. Positioned if, or we can do positioned as at a if. So block basically means it's going to test one block below you. Blocks test a volume of blocks, and entity just tests if we have another entity. So entity basically means if there is another player, closest player r equals one. If there's a player, so it's going to test all players and the test if there's a player near them. So if there's a player in a radius of 10, and we're going to do rm equals 1, meaning we don't want to select that player. We're going to do if there's a player next to that player, we're going to run say hey. So obviously I don't have a player next to me, but we could also do the same thing with entities. So I don't have an entity near me, but if I go to just find a random entity. Nope, cow. If I run this, you can see it's saying, hey, because there's an entity in a radius of 10 blocks of me. I think we do still need this RM. Yeah, you still need it. So basically why I'm putting RM, it's meaning do not select me, do not select my player, because I want to select a radius outside that player. So do not select this player. We want to select everything in a radius maximum, meaning the maximum radius outside of me. Or actually, I think it means something else, not radius maximum. But it basically means if there's a circle around me of one block, it's selecting everything outside of that and not selecting this block. So everything outside in a radius that r equals 10, so radius of 10 and a radius maximum of 1. Might be something else, not maximum, but basically means select everything outside of a block of one around me. If I change that to two, same thing, two blocks around me. So yeah, that is the new slash execute command. It's very, very cool. There's also a little bit more documentation and help. If this video did not help, make sure to help me understand why it didn't help, and also other things I can improve on with this. Make sure to check out the documentation. I will leave this in the description. The documentation basically goes through stuff I've talked about in this video and also talks about more, a little bit more in depth, a little bit more stuff that you might want to know, and you might want to need to know about the new execute command. So as always, make sure to subscribe, comment, and like this video if it was helpful, because that will show YouTube algorithm that you like this video and it will lead it to more players. So make sure to like this video, very important, and also join the Smelly Curry Discord, because this is the only place you can get access to these downloads, these announcements, and any other things that is released for my channel. It's very, very beneficial that you join this. If you do like my videos and you do want to stay a part of my community and all that stuff. So I will leave the Discord link in the bio. It's also always in my YouTube page. Make sure to keep learning, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.